we can probably get a better impression of Sans Pareil by having a quick look at the replica. Now, made in 1979 for the 150th anniversary of the Rainhill Trials, it was built here in Shildon by British Rail Engineering Limited and apprentices. So it's a fully working replica. It has the ability to do what the original engine did, but we would never dream of restoring the original Sans Pareil to operation now. But this encapsulates several generations of Shildon pride, not just pride from Hackworth from 1829, but the pride of the apprentices who made that engine and made it take its place in 1979 and 1980 at the 150th anniversary of the Liverpool and Manchester Railway. So we get a bit more of an impression of the engine from this working replica. It's actually slightly smaller than the real one. It's more like a 7/8 scale, because had the replica been built to the full scale of the original one, it would never have fitted on British Rail network in the 1980s. So here again, this is the front of the engine as it would have led a train with the driving platform. There's that pump, the troublesome pump, which on the replica has also caused problems in the past. If it gets cold and left out in the frost, it breaks and needs to be replaced. That's exactly what's happened to this machine here. And there is more of that reversing gear with the two handles. And then the steam regulator valve, that long handle reaching through. We also talked about the safety of these machines and Hackworth's innovation, not just that one of connecting the pistons and the cylinders to the wheels directly, but the spring-loaded safety valve. And here on the replica Sans Pareil, there is indeed a Hackworth pattern safety valve. So what this does is it keeps the pressure within the boiler to a certain level, but if the pressure gets too high, then the springs, the steam pressure pushes against the springs and lets the excess steam out. Now, that is a really good safety measure, because before that, all the engines had were one of these, which is a deadweight safety valve, where there's a big weight on the end that holds the valve down and steam can push against the weight and get out. But the big flaw with this is that if you want a bit more oomph out of your engine, you tie it down or hold it down. If you're lucky, you get away with it. If you're unlucky, it's half a day out with the undertaker. But then moving on to the rest of the engine, this is what you can't see on the original, because the replica has a tender, four-wheel wooden tender with a water barrel at the back and storage space for coal or coke in there. And then you can see the fireman has direct access to the fire grate, which is more complete on this being a working engine. And there you can actually see the fire bars there with an ash pan underneath, so that they could rake out all the byproduct. Because this is a more modern working replica of the engine, we have to have some more modern safety devices on it, safety features. So there is our steam pressure gauge, which tells us that the engine can work. That red line there shows us that the engine lets off steam at 50 pounds per square inch. And there's also a water level gauge. We talked about Hackworth's engine water pump failing and the fusible plug in the firebox melting, meaning game over. That gives the modern fireman of Sans Pareil a much better impression of what's happening and where the level of water is in the engine. So whilst it's still a very basic machine, it has to have a few more modern accoutrements. And there is the little plaque on the tender that tells us that this engine took its place in the recreation of the Rainhill Trials and the cavalcade of the anniversary at Rainhill in May 1980. And I was there. I was 6 years old and my dad took me to see it. And on the very first day of the cavalcade, Sans Pareil had problems. And I can remember it being dragged along at the beginning of the parade by a scruffy blue diesel shunter. Now, by the end of the cavalcade that day, the engine had got up steam and it was able to operate again. But that impression has stuck into my mind for the past 40 odd years. I wonder what impression the original Sans Pareil made in 1829.